Welcome back. How to avoid mouth odor? Now that matter, and I won't discuss now on top of the Good Morning Naija show. We talk hint some small yesterday. Say, how you want tell person when you get mouth odor? Say, in mouth they smell without to offend the person. People just they carry different opinion. I go call them one side. I go do this one. But I want to sure say you self when one call person one on one. Not be you people. They even they try they avoid. Yes, how we won't stop this matter or how to prevent them. Dr. Ridwan Adekola, when be dentist, now you go join us for this segment to tell us how we fit avoid mouth odor. And again, to avoid them, we must know what in the cause. Dr. Ridwan, good morning.
Good morning.
Good. Thank you, sir, as you join us for our show this morning. Will they talk this issue of mouth odor matter? What in the first cause this matter? Person go sit down saying, don't brush mouth, brush mouth, brush mouth. Still, mouth, they smell. Why?
Well, thank you very much. Mouth odor is just a subjective perception that someone's mouth is smelling in a layman term. And what are the causes of mouth odor? Usually, we dentists divide it into two basic aspects. One is from the mouth, then the other division is from other part of the body. 90% of the time.
Dr. Ridwan, as you talk, your mouth self they disappear. Help us adjust your screen small so we go. We will see person when they tell us true. Oh yeah, continue.
Is it better now?
Yes, much better. Oh yeah, they talk.
All right. So I said 90% of the times usually from causes from the mouth, okay. And mostly is usually caused by death or what we call plaque and calculus that surrounds our teeth in the mouth. So basically, those are the causes of mouth odor.
Okay. My person on the brush tongue, that one too, they cause some?
Yes. Mm. Absolutely.
Okay.
Like I said, plaque and calculus in form of death are mostly the causes of mouth odor. Okay. So whenever you see those whitish, yellowish stuff that usually are on teeth, and sometimes whitish slough on the tongue, those are the causes of mouth odor.
Are they here so say gum disease, self, they cause some?
Yes. The genesis of gum disease starts from the death, the plaque and calculus that I talked about. You understand? So okay. It's those plaque and calculus are bacteria that leads to the gum disease.
Okay. All right. Oh yeah, make we talk how we want to even prevent this our matter now. How we want to treat them? Because person go say now, first of all, no say you get mouth odor. And we don't understand, say people when get mouth odor, no, they know say that they get mouth odor. So mouth odor they affect nose. When we say person when get them, no, they know say they get them. Because if you know say you get them, you can't begin to find the solution. So how we want to ensure say person feel smell, maybe they do like this from time to time. I mean get tested so if you do to know that you get mouth odor or not.
Okay. For individuals that have mouth odor, the most important thing is for them to brush twice daily.
Okay.
Very, very important. And so that's twice daily involves brushing after eating in the morning and also before sleeping at night. Usually people will say that they can't eat before brushing. So usually because they feel their mouth somehow. But if they brush before they sleep at night, then definitely their mouth will be in good condition in the morning. Most diseases of mouths, like I said, are caused by bacteria and they are most active when we are asleep. So whenever you see them doing that part in the television saying that you should brush before at night, it's not because of they want you to bite their toothpaste, but it's very, very important to brush before you sleep at night. Then okay. After you finish eating in the morning.
Okay, so if you say if you say it is good to brush after you don't eat breakfast, not brush before you chop breakfast.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, mommy, they here. Because if I carry food for my mama, go tell me, say, have you brushed this morning and you're already eating? Mommy, now they here, or they say, make with a chop. Make I chop it before I brush my mouth. Make like they carry on a brush, they go office with that. Now, so we'll go take this quick break. When we come back, we will discuss more on top how to avoid or how to prevent this mouth odor matter. No go anywhere. We'll return soon. Brush your mouth after you chop breakfast, not before. When are they here? Nobody know the flog on a picking on top of the matter. Yes, because those things will come remain for inside mouth. To people will come suffer till they reach for night. Come brush again. Dr. Ridwan, don't tell us as it be. But Dr. Ridwan, I go also want to know, it gets certain food where person supposed avoid. That's a situation where we say your office not to get where you feel brush mouth. Because people come, they look and say, wait, too. Somebody they chop, you know, food until they reach office. I say, you know, somebody also chop food inside bus as then they go work. Let me say, mask go smell as then they for that corner. So, in case for a person fit avoid to reduce this mouth odor matter, how if you manage them?
Okay. The other causes of mouth odor include odoriferic food substances. We all know them. Food substances like locust beans, garlic, onion, kola nut, and the like. When you heat it and you don't brush, individual will have mouth odor. That one is normal. Is there any food substances you have to eat to help with your mouth odor? Basically, not really, but okay. You can take mint substances. Either you use a mint toothpaste or mint mouth wash. Also very important from that is that we need to visit our dentist twice in a year, at least twice in a year, because even the best mouth brushers, they cannot remove all the dirt in the mouth. So with time, there are some that will accumulate on the teeth and they will stick to the teeth that normal toothbrush will not remove. So you need a dentist to use their machine in their office to help you professionally remove those dirt.
And to also check whether the person don't go get gum disease. Well, the person, if they look and say, I've been brushing, I've been doing everything, my mouth still the smell. They don't go understand why it is smell. What is the quickest test for a person know whether my mouth they smell? Now, only like this, or when person wear face mask. Because you know, say, me too, they do, and they check myself from time to time. You know, say, you just sit down. You guess you would go like, what did they happen? Or maybe when person don't move back small, or won't even dab as you they talk. So help us. How we feel they check ourselves before we wreck other people?
All right. Like I said earlier, mouth odor, when I was defining, I said it's subjective.
Okay.
Even professionals, when they want to detect mouth odor, usually subjective. What we usually do is that we stand at a distance to the patient, usually around 50 centimeters or so. And we just discuss with the patient and see if we can perceive mouth odor. There's also the aspect of mouth odor that is psychogenic. Okay. It has been researched that out of every 10 individuals that visit the dentist for complaint of mouth odor, only 3 out of those 10 usually actually have the mouth odor. Most times it's just psychogenic. You see people like teachers and pastors and like presenting in the clinic that they have mouth odor. They will tell you that. I will ask them, is there a colleague or your partner that told you that you had mouth odor? They will say no. That they usually notice maybe when they are speaking in class or to their church member, people are covering their mouth or so. And it's not. Maybe those people are just itching their nose at that particular time.
So when you say psychogenic, now that's for their mind today.
Yes, just their mind is playing trick on them that they have mouth odor and they don't actually have the mouth
But the test of to pray, that one they ever fail, so now they give you the right result.
Which one is that?
As my hand on cup like this now, I put them for my nose, put them for my mouth.
It won't give you the right result.
Oh, really?
Because, yes, even at rest, some scent will come out of your mouth. Like I told you, even professional, you have to stand at a distance the patient, not move entirely close to them to perceive the odor. Usually we say 50 centimeters from the patient, and you see if you can perceive the odor. If you can perceive at that distance, then patient has mouth.
So the best way now to use another person test them. Just tell the person best stand for them. As they talk, if they smell anything, well, beside the person, when beside the end of that test, now yes, your mouth is smell, because now you go first collect the first smell when go come out. But Dr. Ridwan, thank you so much for your contribution for our show. This one, Dr. Ridwan, they call him the dentist, and he already talk him as he be. I bet people will tell you they struggle to wash till phone and chop breakfast. Into say not be so. Chop your food, then brush your mouth later. When you reach house, also chop your food, then brush your mouth before you sleep. So in the talk, I know say different rules go to come out. But if you say, not the one when they work for you, as long as say, when you they say hello, Puna say hello, or Puna say hello, I'm going to say, don't worry, away from there, maintain social distance. Maybe on top of coronavirus, so on top of them, we follow up your mouth, they come out. But we go come back. I'm sorry, good morning, Niger Show. Our Twitter, I'm a boy, today on ground. Chukwudezugu, go join me for that segment. No come out.